bass is one of the most important instruments that plays a crucial role in films. It can create tension, excitement, and physical sensation. You can hear it, and in some setups, you can't even feel it. And for me, nothing creates forward motion like a solid, low pulsing bass line in the middle of an action scene. Hey everyone, welcome to another product video. Today I'll be unboxing the new REL Acoustics T7X Piano Black Subwoofer. Take a closer look at its features, see if I can hear a thing or two different compared to my Creaks Volcanic subwoofers, and of course, ask the question, is it worth it? Don't go away. As we all know, recently the new REL TX series was replaced by the TI series in the subwoofer world. It comes in three ranges, the smallest being the T5X, of course the middle being the T7X, and the big bad boy being the T9X. I chose to unbox the T7X because I think it's a sweet spot in terms of price and performance. In the box, it comes with the power cable, of course your user manual, and 10 meters of the famous Nutrix Speak On stereo cable. For those who own REL subwoofers know that REL has always battled above average in making good subwoofers that integrates well into a domestic audio system. I personally think the TS lineup, which is the highest, are ridiculously good looking and puts some very well known brands in its place. It measures at 14 inches wide by 14.3 inches deep and 12.6 inches in height. It's actually not too heavy, weighing in at 38.5 lbs, with an LF response of 31 Hz at minus 6 dB. I am surprisingly really digging it, like a lot. This subwoofer truly excites me. I don't know why, but it puts a big smile on my face. Maybe it's because it's not your typical looking subwoofer, or maybe it's the curvy edges, or is it because it is piano black color? But I think it's a bit of everything, to be honest, and I truly believe they have really nailed this one. Let's take a closer look. When you look face on, you're gridded with, of course, the high quality subwoofer grille, followed by a 200mm long throw fiber alloy active driver with the logo in the middle. I think it looks really nice, but would have liked them silver screws to be black maybe. What do you guys think? Bottom view of the unit has some changes, such as the design of the new high density feet, which seems to have more of a rectangular shape with curved edges, matching the aesthetics. I kinda like these a lot more, they seem solid and the logo on it just feels like it's the correct size, but I would have preferred a more understated look. It still has the same 10 inch downfiring passive radiator for that full rumble, but with the inverted alloy dust cap housed in the steel chassis and the REL logo. The backing of this subwoofer is almost identical to the T7i series. Starting from the top to the left is the REL logo, followed by the wireless interface socket. This is used to connect to REL wireless, which we'll talk about in a few moments. Then you have your controls, such as setting the phase up to 180 degrees, the volume control for high and low input, adjust your crossover frequency levels that's variable between 20 to 120 Hz. Moving down is the low level RCA input, as well as the 0.1 LFE level that's used to adjust output level from your surround sound processor. And then we have the one of the unique secrets of REL success, the Nutrix Speak On high level input, which is used to connect to the main front amplifier speaker terminals, red and yellow going to the left and right positive terminals, while the black wire is connected to one of the two negative terminals. This is actually my first time seeing this. I've never used something like this before. It does say you can also hook it up in many different ways. So it should be interesting. This unique function alone is a whole nother video, but if any of you guys are interested in this topic, I'll put some links down below in the description box, so check it out for better understanding of what it does. Then we have the 0.1 LFE RCA input, your power on off indicator with the turning on and off switch of the subwoofer, and lastly, the fused main power socket. To its side, of course, you cannot miss the enormous heatsink sticking out because of its 200 watt RMS rated Class AB high current amplifier. Flipping back to the top is a centered REL logo, nice and simple, and on either side you have this beautifully painted 5-code piano black color, which is kind of growing on me. Going back to the Ariel wireless socket, I believe this option is also available for the T7i series. Being the fastest wireless system available in the industry, this subwoofer is so dynamic, has zero compression thanks to the single large scale integrated chip. One thing that kind of puts a question mark for me is why do you have to purchase these separately? But anyway, I think this great looking compact subwoofer aesthetically fits perfect in a small to medium sized living room space or even in a dedicated home theater room if you wish. Definitely has the wife approved appeal to it because it doesn't really stand out too much. It has plenty of grunt and sounds super tasty, but I do feel that in an open space like my living room, the 7X is a little underwhelming, or maybe I'm just used to my Creek's volcanic subwoofer. But to be fair, I can't even compare the two because of how different they are. But the Creek's does seem to have a lot more depth and a lot more in the lower end. You can actually feel it in your body. In saying that, maybe the T9X would be the better choice in an open space like this, which of course is bigger in size and weight, costs a lot more, equipped with a 10-inch active driver instead of 8, generating a lot more power, 300 watts RMS to be exact. If the 7X or 9X is too much for you, the lowest 5X range is another great little beauty, which features one down-firing 8-inch active driver that drops down to 120 watts RMS and of course is smaller in size, which leads to a smaller price tag. Across the entire high-low range, this subwoofer sounds incredible. I paired this with my older Polk TSI 500 floor standing speakers and instantly I heard depth in the mid-range that wasn't there before, but not in a way that the tonality of the speakers changed. The highs were clearer and seemed more detailed and the lows were a lot more immersive. In fact, the whole soundstage also benefited from the additional of the subwoofer. My Creek's volcanic subwoofer definitely did not do anything like this. Compared to the TI series, the TX is instantly seen crispier, more modern with the fresh look, faster of course thanks to them fiber alloy dust caps that produce higher output levels and adds weight to the bass. I think their goal here was to deliver a budget style of the latest S series, which makes sense when you see it and hear it. Of course, those big explosions that shake the entire room matters when watching an action movie. But in this case, I don't think the TX7 is marketed or designed for that, even though it can produce clean, superb blows of believable, energetic, intense bass. In my honest opinion, I think it's designed 75% more for hi-fi two-channel music use, but still has the ability to perform and speak home cinema. The speed of the T7X is its outstanding feature. In fact, I don't think I've ever heard a subwoofer like it for a similar price, and for that alone, it deserves a high praise. Couple this with some awesome new hi-fi or home theater floor standing speakers, and I guarantee you, you'll be smiling for days. The T7X retails for about $2,000 and has been in the market for a couple of months now, and if you own one of these, the 5 or even 9 series, or even the older TI series, let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. This subwoofer was a lot of fun. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and take into consideration that this isn't the full review video, which is in my to-do list, but with how busy I've been lately, I have no idea when that would be. Thank you guys for watching. Appreciate every single one of you guys, especially all you early birds in the comment section. Hit that like button if you haven't already. And in my next video, you'll be seeing a glimpse of my mini portable home theater room, which I'm really excited about. Take care of yourself and I'll see you guys soon. Peace.